morning in Paris, the city awakes to the bells of Notre Dame. The fisherman fishes, the baker man bakes to the bells of Notre Dame. To the big bells as loud as the thunder, to the little bells soft as a psalm. And some say the soul of the city is the toll of the bells. The bells of Notre Dame. This, they're beautiful, no? So many colors of sound, so many changing moods. Because, you know, they do not ring all by themselves.
They don't?
Oh, silly boy. Up there, high, high in the dark bell tower, lives the mysterious bell ringer. Who is this creature?
Who?
What is he?
What?
How did he come to be there?
How?
Hush! And Clopin will tell you. It is a tale. A tale of a man and a monster. Dark was the night when our tale was begun on the docks near Notre Dame.
Shut it up, will you? We'll be spotted.
Hush, little one.
Forthright then the gypsies slid silently under the docks near Notre Dame.
Four guilders for safe passage into Paris.
But a trap had been laid for the gypsies, and they gazed up in fear and alarm at a figure whose clutches were iron as much as the bell.
Judge Claude Rollo, the bells
of Notre Dame. Judge Claude Frollo longed to purge the world of vice and sin. And he saw corruption everywhere except within.
Bring these vermin to the Palace of Justice.
You there! What are you hiding?
Stolen goods, no doubt. Take them from her.
She ran. One time in his life of power and control, Frollo felt a twinge of fear for his immortal soul.
What must I do?
Care for the child and raise it as your own.
What? I am to be saddled with this misshapen.
Very well. But let him live with you in your church.
Live here? Where?
Anywhere. Just so he's kept locked away where no one else can see. The bell tower, perhaps. And who knows, our Lord works in mysterious ways. Even this foul creature may yet prove one day to be of use to me.
And Frollo gave the child a cruel name. A name that means half-formed, Quasimodo.